the sake of posterity, that would be wonderful in this guest book, which is out there on the table, where there's also the compact discs. I didn't know they had them. I would have pushed them shamelessly. $15 a piece. Autographed copies, if you so desire, yeah.
I like the music behind it.
Yeah.
Very nice. You guys are real pros, aren't you?
Been on this around.
I've done it before.
All right, yeah, I am loving the heck out of it. So, without, you want
to... Yeah, he's trying to get through. Call me. Call me.
What
kind of beers
that
you have there?
You regular
with
these things?
Are we all set? So once again, please make welcome.
Again.
Younger and Molly Mason.
Yay! Yay!
Well, let's start right off singing something together.
Okay.
Yeah. I surprised her.
Sure.
Okay, this is a song that we knew about but didn't start singing until
tonight.
Our daughter and son-in-law got married in, what year was that, 2008, something like that. Our friend and their friend, Carter Little, sang it at the wedding ceremony. It's called The Gumtr Canoe, and it's kind of a love story. But then we learned a little more about it, and it's probably about two slaves who were lovers, and slaves couldn't marry. But they did have some time off now and then at the end of a work day, and the probable backstory is, let's say it might have been a Sunday evening each week, they could get in a canoe and paddle out and paddle back, you know, as a little leisure activity. And after a few months or years of that, people got so used to seeing them do it that one night when they paddled out and didn't come back, nobody noticed for quite a while. So that's what the song's about. And when they paddle out there, they eventually find a ship with a flag of true blue. Maybe that was a Union ship, and it rescues them. So here it is. On the Tombigbee River, so bright I was born. Tall yellow corn. It was there that I first met my Julia so true. And I rode her around in my gum tree canoe, singing, row. Thank you. Gumtr.